Section 4, Annuities, Present Value, and Amortization. So suppose that at the end of each year, for the next 10 years, $500 is deposited in a savings account, paying 7% interest compounded annually. Okay, so end of the year back here tells us this is an ordinary annuity. Now suppose that you wanted to, rather than pay a yearly payment, okay, or even monthly in some cases, you wanted to put some amount into a savings account one time, just once, and achieve that same result. Okay, that's what present value is. We want to know, so the present value of an annuity is the amount that could be deposited in one lump sum in order to have the same balance at the end of an annuity. Okay, so you're lazy, you only want to do it once. Okay, it's probably going to be a lot higher. Okay, but that's what it is. We're just after what we could do now to achieve some amount later. That's all present value ever turns out to be. Okay, so effectively we want to solve this equation. Okay, we want the compound interest to equal the amount in the annuity. Okay, so we want to solve this for P so that we can know the principal, okay, or the present value, if you want to say it that way, that would have the same balance. Okay, so if we actually divided by the 1 plus I to the N, divided by 1 plus I to the N, okay, and did some work with the distributive property and some exponent properties, you'd end up with this equation right here. So the present value P of an annuity of N payments of R dollars each at the end of consecutive interest periods with interest compounded at a rate of I per period is this guy, P equals R, big parentheses, 1 minus 1 plus I to the negative N divided by I. And as usual, N is M times T, okay, and I is the rate per compounding period, so I is R divided by M. Okay, so first example here, John Cross and Wendy Mears are both graduates of the Brisbane Institute of Technology. They both agree to contribute to the endowment fund of BIT. John says that he will give $500 at the end of each year for 9 years. Wendy prefers to give a lump sum today. What lump sum can she give that will equal the present value of John's annual gifts if the endowment fund earns 7.5% compounded annually? So the fact that she wants to give a lump sum, okay, tells us that we are working with present value. So we know that P, or our R, our payment, capital R, is 500. That's what John is going to give each month or each year at the end of each year, okay, for 9 years. So he's depositing it yearly, so compounding any of that actually goes together, M equals 1. We have a rate of lowercase r, 7.5%. So going back to that equation, we have, let me write that here, P equals R times 1 plus, no, 1 minus, minus 1 plus I to the negative N over I. Oh my, I just wrote the wrong equation. I looked at the wrong one. It is 1 minus 1 plus I to the negative, nope, that's right. Okay, so there's our equation. So we're going to plug in the values we know. So P equals 500, okay, 1 minus, let's see, 1 plus I, which is 0.075 over 1, because that's our compounding amount, compounding periods, to the negative N. Well, N is M times T. Okay, so we actually need M is 1 times 9, so 1 times 9, okay, divided by 1 times 9, divided by 0.075 over 1. Lots of parentheses in there. All right, but if we do work that out, we should get a total of $3,189.44 when we round. So if she gives $3,189 today, just once, versus his $500 a year at the end of each year for 9 years, those actually should come out to be the same when she deposits and it compounds and his goes through just through the endowment fund. Okay, next example. Example 2, find the present value of an annuity of $120, capital R, at the end of each month. Okay, put into account yielding 4.8%, lowercase r, compounded monthly, M equals 12 for 5 years. There's our T. So P equals R, so 120. Big parentheses, I need to use big ones there. 1 minus 1 plus I, so that's 0.048, divided by 12. Okay, to the negative n, well, that is 12 times 5, all divided by 0.048 divided by 12. All right. And as always, you should probably be working this with me or pause and work it yourself. That way you know you can get these answers. But this answer should come out to be that the present value is $6,389.86. All right, so one of the most important issues with annuities and uses that we can have is in determining the equal monthly payments that you need to pay off a loan. Okay, so in our example 3, we have that a car costs $19,000. After a down payment of $2,000, the balance will be paid off in 36 equal monthly payments with an interest of 6% per year on the unpaid balance. So find the amount of each payment. So in this case, the unknown is the payment. We don't know what R is. Okay, so that equation was P equals, so we'll have our P. But wait, how much is this loan actually going to be for? It's not going to be for $19,000. It's $19,000, and a down payment means you take that off. So $19,000 minus the $2,000. So our actual balance, the balance is $17,000. So we're going to have $17,000 equals R times some stuff here, 1 minus 1 plus, and let's see, we need R, our R is 6%, 36 payments, that's actually N, N is the number of payments, and compounding, let's see, they're monthly payments, so actually they're going to be compounded monthly. Okay, so it's going to be compounded monthly. So we're going to take 0.06 divided by 12 to the negative n. Well, n is 36. The negative 36 divided by 0.06 over 12. Okay. Now we can't just we could type in this amount right here. Okay, and then we're going to have to take 17,000 divided by that amount there. So I'm just going to go ahead and do that. In my calculator, I'm going to type 17,000 divided by this stuff right here, whatever that is. Okay, and so my R value ends up being 517.17, so $517.17. That is the payment that she's going to have every month. Okay. Now, we're going to have to extend this just a little bit. When we have these payments that she's making, okay? Each payment on this loan includes interest on the unpaid balance, and the remaining amount goes to principal. Okay, so in this example, the interest that's included comes to $85. Okay, so 6% divided by 12, that's 0.05. So 0.005 times the 17,000, that's the interest. Okay, so now she's made a $517 payment, but only 85 of that goes to interest, and the rest of that goes towards actually paying off the loan that she has. And that's really where we're headed now, amortization. Okay, if you're familiar with any foreign languages at all, amort or mort generally means death. Okay, and that's really what this is death of a loan. So a loan is amortized if both the principal and the interest are paid by a sequence of equal periodic payments. The periodic payment R can be calculated by solving the present value formula for R. This is actually what I did. I took the principal, or the present value, divided it by that big quantity. That's what I did. Okay, so a loan of P dollars at an interest rate I per period may be amortized in N equal periodic payments of R dollars made at the end of each period where R, the payment, is this quantity. You can use either one of these. This is actually a little more simplified, so remember flip the fraction, the reciprocal, the I at the top. So same formula right there. I like this because it's a little simpler. Okay, so we're going to use that for a couple of loans. The Perez family buys a house for $275,000 with a down payment of $55,000. They take out a 30-year mortgage. Okay, 30-year mortgage. If I can use a different color there. So there's our T. For $220,000. That is now the present value. They've already subtracted this for us. At an annual interest rate of 6%, lowercase r. Now, notice that although the interest rate is an annual interest rate, we assume that it's compounded monthly. Okay, so you may not see that it's compounded monthly, but this one is because they're going to make monthly payments. Okay, so find the amount of the monthly payment needed to amortize this loan. Okay, so we are going to take that formula we had earlier, R equals P times I over 1 minus 1 plus I to the negative n. Okay, that's the formula we're going to plug into. So we are going to take our principal, our present value, $220,000 times I, which is going to be 0.06 over 12, divided by 1 minus 1 plus 0.06 divided by 12 to the negative, how many payments are we making? We're making 30 payments, 30 years, 12 payments a year, so 360 right there. Okay, so if we calculate what this actually comes down to be, our payment should be $1,319.01. Okay, so there's our payment. All right. Now, let's actually see how much interest we have. In part B, we're going to take the payment we just calculated. Same problem, but find the total amount of interest paid when loan is amortized over 30 years. So when it's done that way, we have $1,319.01. So how much did we actually pay? We paid over 30 years, 12 times a year. So that actually comes out to be $474,843.60. All right, so this is the total amount of payments. These are our payments. Okay. Now, we actually want to know how much interest there is, so we need to subtract the actual amount of the loan, okay, the $220,000. If we subtract those two, that'll give us our interest. So in this case, our interest is $254,843.60. That is a lot of interest. A lot of interest. Over 30 years, you accumulate, there's a lot of excess you're paying in there. So if you think about this, let me actually do this as an aside. Okay. So if you actually had, instead of finding out the payments including the interest, if you just took that $220,000 and you divided that by, I don't need subtraction there, and you divided that by 30 payments times 12 a year, let's see what that is. Let's see. 220,000 divided by 360. That would give us $611. Okay, so your payment should be $611 if you were only paying the principal. However, including the interest, you're paying $1,300 a month. Though that is a lot. That is, what, $700 in interest every month? So it accumulates pretty darn fast. All right, next part of this we're going to look at is finding the part of the first payment that's interest and the part that's applied to reducing the debt. Okay, so the $220,000, if we want just interest on that, it's 0.06 over 12. Okay, so that is actually $1,100. So that is interest on that first payment. Okay, interest. Okay, that's interest on the first payment. Okay, so that means out of our payment that was $1,319.01, that means that going to the principal paying off the loan is $219.01. Okay, so this is actually looking forward to how much interest over the long run you're going to have. Rather than just paying $700 a month, you're paying a lot of interest on that first payment. Okay, but and just paying off the loan is that much. That's measly. But actually, we'll see what happens over time here in a minute as you actually pay off a loan. All right. Example 5. Amy Egan borrows $1,000 for 1 year at 12% annual interest compounded monthly. Okay, so there is our payment. There is our time at 1 year. 12% is our lowercase r. And it's compounded monthly, so m equals 12. All right, so we're going to calculate this using that previous formula. So we're going to have r equals p, which is 1,000. Oh, I wrote that wrong. We're finding the payment. I actually wrote right the first time. That is P. That's just the total borrowed amount. All right, so P on top times 0.12 over 12, because it's monthly, divided by 1 minus 1 plus I, so that's 0.12 over 12, to the negative number of payments. So there are, it's 1 year at 12 times a year, so we make 12 payments. All right. And so, therefore, our payment is $88.85. All right, there's our payment. Now, this next problem, actually, this next part of this problem, brings up a really interesting point. After she makes 3 payments, she decides to pay off the remaining balance all at once. How much does she pay? How much is actually left on it once she pays that? Okay, now, this formula actually is identical to the present value formula. Okay, if you go way back to the beginning, it's almost identical, except instead of B for balance, we have present value, and instead of this N minus X, we just have N. Okay, so what that actually means right here is that this is how many payments you have left. So in our case, she had 12 payments. She's made 3, so there are 9 left. So this exponent's going to be a 9. Okay, and that's just going to tell us the remaining balance. Okay, so it's going to turn into this. Our balance equals 88.85, we had to use the number from up here, 1 minus 1 plus 0.12 over 12. Okay, and if you take negative 12 minus 3, you get the 9 that I was saying earlier. Okay, divided by 0.12 over 12. So if we calculate this, the balance ends up being $761.09. Okay, now, how accurate is that really, you might ask? It's pretty close. So the next thing we're going to actually talk about is paying off loans. This is just the remaining balance. We're going to come back to this formula a little bit. But we're actually going to see how you actually calculate these things in real life. Okay, in business, it's important to calculate loan amounts very accurately and unambiguously as possible. Amortization schedules, or tables, do this. They list how much of each payment is interest and how much goes to reduce the balance, as well as how much is owed after each payment. This is where it comes in, going back to that problem. Okay, so Amy Egan borrows $1,000 for 1 year at 12% interest compounded monthly. Okay, so this is actually using the problem we had earlier. But using her monthly payments that we found, 88.85, that's going to be in this table right there, in that column, okay, we are going to complete this amortization schedule for this loan. Okay, so after she makes 0 payments, she doesn't owe anything yet. There's no interest. Nothing's changed there. It just starts at $1,000. All right, so how are we going to find the amount of interest? Well, the interest is going to be the principal that we have left times our rate. So in this case, that is going to be our I is 0.12 over 12. So we are going to take, our principal times 0.01 every time. So 1,000 times 0.01 is $10. $10 a year. So that means of this 88.85, she's actually going to put 78.85 toward the principal. Okay, not so bad. Then she's going to take this amount of principal, and it's going to change because she just paid $78.85 towards it. So now she only owes $921.15. Okay? We're going to do that same thing every time. So now we're going to take 921.15 times 0.01 to get an interest of $9.21. So we're going to pay that much in interest. Take that away from here. Subtract 88.85 minus 921 to get 79.64. Okay, so that's how much is going towards the principal. So now we'll take 921, take 79.64 away from it, and get 841.51. Okay? So, as you can see, her principal is actually decreasing. She's paying off the loan. If these numbers aren't going down, you are doing something terribly wrong because your principal is going up. Okay, so we kind of continue this pattern. So take 841.51 times 0.01 to get 842. Okay, take 842 away from 88.85 and get $80.43. Okay, and then we'll take this $80.43 from 841.51 and get 761.08, which there's the amount we said she owed after three payments, right? 761.09 is what we came up with, so it's pretty close, within a penny. Probably some rounding error in there. Okay, next one, let's multiply that by 0.01, so we get $7.61. Take it away from the 88, the payment there, and we get 81.24. Now take that away from the principal, and we get 679.84. Okay, pause the video. I'm going to actually complete this table real quick so you can see what the answer should be. So pause it and check it in a second. Okay, so a couple of things that I want to point out about this. Notice that the amount of interest is actually going down. Amount paid towards interest. The amount that's being paid towards the principal is going up. That's good. The payments are more effective as time goes on. Now, I kind of want to make a note about this last payment right here. You may have ended up with something weird here. Okay, if you actually calculate the interest, I didn't do that yet, but it's 88 cents for that last payment. It's doing over 12 months. Now, the portion towards principal, actually, there's only $87.96 left. If you put the 88.85, you end up with a negative amount here. Okay, so let's go ahead and do that. 88.85, or if you subtract that, you get 87.96, no, you get 87 something. 88.85 minus 0.88 is 87.97. And so you get minus 0.1 cent there. So what we need to do is we're going to take this payment over here and slice it. And we're going to change that to 88.84, change that to 87.96, and we get zero. We want to end up with zero at the end, owing nothing. Okay. I think that's all we've got on these. Okay, these are a kind of a pain to do by hand. There is a way for your calculator to do it. Okay, if I get a chance, I'll show you how to do that. It's not exactly real straightforward, but you can do it. All right. Example 7, our last one. Given a loan of $140,000, compounded quarterly at a rate of 8%, paid over 15 quarterly payments. So we're given this. We want to find the payment necessary to amortize this loan. All right, so that's R equals, I'm going to write the equation again, P times I over 1 minus 1 plus I to the negative n. Okay. So we're going to take $140,000 times 0.08, and it's quarterly, so divided by 4. I didn't label this, did I? Present value, compounded quarterly, m equals 4, rate, lowercase r is 8%, over 15 quarterly payments. That's not years, that's how many quarters they paid. Okay, so 1 minus 1 plus 0.08 over 4 to the negative 15, because we know that there are 15 payments. All right. Okay. So that amount should come out to be where did I leave it? There we go. $10,895.57. Okay. Pretty big payment, but they're also paying it off in 15 payments, not 30 years and things like that. So they're only making like something like, well, 15 payments, it's only a couple of years actually. So in quarters, that's 3 years, three and three quarters of years. Okay. Part B, total payments and the amount of interest paid based on calculated payments. So the 1095 or 10895.57, making that over 15 payments. So the grand total is $163,433.49. Okay, so those are just our payments. And some space here. Okay, those are just payments. Okay, now we'll subtract the interest. Well, not the interest. We'll subtract the amount of the loan, $140,000. And that will give us our interest. So the interest is $23,433.49. All right, so we were asked to calculate both of those, so there they are. All right, last question. Suppose that after 5 quarters, the loan is paid off in full. Calculate the amount needed to pay off the loan at that point. All right, so we had this other formula, B equals. All right, so we're going to take our payment, which we have calculated to be $10,895.49.57. Okay, times our interest. Oh, big parentheses again. Okay, I've got 1 minus 1 plus 0.08 over 4 to the negative 10 because she's paid 5 quarters out of 15. So there are 10 left divided by 0.08 over 4. So the remaining balance is now $97,870.38. There's our balance. Okay, that brings us to the end of this section on annuities. And the next thing we have up should actually be a test over this. So we may be spending some time reviewing this. All right, so let's get on our assignment.